Designing a Basemap, Part 7, Cartographic Typography. In the previous video, you learned how to adjust the line weight and color. In this video, you will learn cartographic typography. In this chapter, you learned that typography is the art and technique of type placement, arrangement, and design for aesthetics, communication, and readability of the written language. Because type is a significant component of every map, cartographic proficiency requires a basic understanding of typography. A skilled cartographer views lettering on maps as both a means to communicate language and as a visual variable, useful in establishing an effective visual hierarchy to reduce initial confusion and enhance communication. On this map, you will practice working with type and label placement by choosing 10 neighborhoods in the city of San Francisco. The purpose of these labels is to identify points of interest as well as to provide a geographic frame of reference to the map reader. In ArcMap, open the Properties for the Neighborhoods layer and navigate to the Labels tab. Near the top left corner of the Layer Properties window, check the box that says Label Features in this layer. Use the drop-down menu next to the Label field to choose Neighborhood from the list of fields. When done, click OK. ArcMap dynamically places labels on the map and does a passable job for many purposes. For advanced cartography, this only provides a place to start. Most projects require careful adjustments to label placement. For this map, these labels will only serve as a reference for you to choose 10 place names. You will eventually turn off the automatic labels. In a previous tutorial, you learned how to activate toolbars. Activate the Draw toolbar and dock it at the top of the ArcMap window. Choose your first area of interest and click the text tool on the Draw toolbar. The icon looks like a letter A. Add the label over the region of interest. If necessary, use the Zoom In tool on the Layout toolbar. Don't worry about the appearance and the exact location for now. You will refine the labels later. Repeat these steps for the remainder of your chosen areas of interest. Be careful with your spelling. When done, open the Neighborhoods layer properties and turn off the automatic labels by unchecking the box in the Labels tab. In this chapter, you learned about typeface and font. A typeface encompasses style and symbology across an entire alphabet, including letters, numbers, and punctuation. A font is a subset of a typeface. It describes a specific size and style of a typeface. Arial, Times, and Courier are all typefaces. Arial Italic 10-point, Times Regular 8-point, Courier Bold 12-point are all fonts because they describe a style, italic, regular, bold, and size, 10, 8, and 12-point. You also discovered that professional type designers classify typefaces into many distinct categories, often based on historical periods and geographic origin. For this tutorial, we will use three broad classifications: serif, sans serif, and display. Sans means without in French. Sans serif typefaces do not have any serifs at the end of stems, while serif typefaces do. Display is a catch-all category of highly stylized typefaces used to catch the reader's attention. Cartographic conventions suggest that you should limit the total number of typefaces on a map. Typically, this means one serif and one sans serif typeface. In this instance, you may also use a display typeface for the poster title to convey a personality, elicit an emotion, or to catch the map reader's attention. Just be sure to never use display type for the main map content. You can edit individual labels by selecting the label, then right-clicking on it to open the Properties window. Click the Change Symbol button for more options. When the Symbol Selector window opens, choose a sans serif typeface, a preliminary font size, and a color. When ready, click OK, then apply to preview your changes. If necessary, change the angle and the character spacing. When ready, click OK. A halo is a drop shadow effect placed under the text. Including a halo behind a label improves legibility by breaking up lines that cross through the text, such as streets and muni routes. You add a halo effect by opening the Label Properties and clicking the Change Symbol button, then clicking the Edit Symbol button. When the Editor window appears, navigate to the Mask tab. Click the radio button next to Halo. The halo is white and sized at 2.0 by default. You can change the color by clicking on the symbol button. The best strategy for picking halo color and weight is to determine if you need high contrast or if you need to blend in with the background. If you have a very busy background, a contrasting halo is often the best choice. If your background has a mostly uniform color with only a few linear features, then choosing the same color as the background is a subtle improvement. Place and style the remaining labels for the areas of interest around the city of San Francisco. Use the layout toolbar to zoom in and out of the poster page as you work to get a sense of how your typographic choices are working. Be sure to resave the map document often so that you do not lose your work. As the last step, add a label for the Pacific Ocean and the San Francisco Bay. As you learned in this chapter, cartographic convention suggests that labels for water features should be italicized and use a serif typeface. In the next video, you will choose a map theme.